our mother, أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she saw رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and she said, أدعو الله لي, as we would have said, make dua for me, O messenger of Allah. She wanted رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in this situation to make dua for him when he is close to his Lord and he's making dua. And he says عليه الصلاة والسلام, اللهم اغفر لعائشة ما تقدم من ذنبها وما تأخر وما أسرت وما أعلنت. Beautiful dua. Oh Allah, forgive Aisha for everything, before and after. All her sins, whether it be before or after. Forgive her for that which she has in secret, and forgive her for that which she does in public. Meaning Allah completely give her complete forgiveness. And Aisha, our mother radiallahu ta'ala anha, she laughed so much of this dua. She was so happy that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made this dua that her head fell back into her house when she was looking outside into the where the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is praying salah in the masjid, and her head goes back into her house out of so much enjoyment. Imagine Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making a dua like that for her, and she laughed so much, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ayasurruki du'ai, that is my dua pleasing to you, are you happy with my dua, O Aisha? فقالت وما لي لا يسرني دعاؤك. She said, why should I not be happy over your dua that you have made for me, O messenger of Allah? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, والله إنها لدعوتي لأمتي في كل صلاة. He said, والله this is my dua for all of my ummah in every single salah. Every time, five times a day with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is saying كل صلاة. Maybe even the non-obligatory salah. Every time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make salah, he would not forget me and you in his salah. He would not forget me and you in his salah, in his dua. And look at how we were important to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at how emotional he became when he thought about me and you. Me and you who don't deserve anything. But look at Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he would recite the ayat about his father Ibrahim. When Ibrahim alaihi wasallam said, رَبِّ إِنَّهُنَّ أَضْلَلْنَ كَثِيرًا مِّنَ النَّاسِ فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي. That the idols, they have caused many people to deviate. For whoever follows me, then he is a part of me. As if to say, oh Allah, look after the believers. And likewise, when he would look at what Isa alayhi salam, his brother, would make, that, and that Allah mentions in the Quran, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكْ, that if you, O Allah, are to punish them, then they are your slaves. You can do whatever you want to them. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ, and O Allah, if you forgive them, then you are the most powerful and the most wise. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he would read these ayat, he would lift his hands to the sky and he would say, Allahumma ummati, ummati. Oh Allah, my ummah. Oh Allah, my ummah. And he would cry, alayhi salatu wassalam. And Allah would send Jibreel and he would say to Jibreel, Ya Jibreel, idhab ila Muhammad wa rabbuka a'lam, fas'alhu ma yubkik. And Allah, seeing the most beloved of his creation crying, Allah would say to Jibreel, go down to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and say to him, oh Muhammad, what is it that makes you cry? وَرَبُّكَ أَعْلَمُ. And Allah knows best as to why he cries. Ask him as to why is he crying. And Jibreel will come down, or came down to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he asked him that Allah asks, why is it that you cry? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informs him as to why he cries. And he comes back to Allah. And Allah says, Ya Jibreel, what is it? What is it that his answer was? And Jibreel tells Allah the answer. And Allah replies, Ya Jibreel, اذهب إلى محمد فقل إنا سنرضيك في أمتك ولا نسوءك. Allah says, now go back to Muhammad, O Jibreel, go back to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and tell him that we will make you pleased with your ummah. We will make you pleased with your ummah and we will not make you upset or feel bad about them. And this is why, because how much concern Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had for us, and Allah loving and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted to please him in every way and in a way that he's most pleased to see his ummah be forgiven.